your non-confirmation,
yes,
as a chairman, substantive chairman of the
EFCC, yes,
has given cause for public concern.
No, no, I don't think so. In fact, I feel it's a lot of encouragement. The fact that I am not confirmed shows I'm working, really. Really, in the entire corruption environment, if they rush to confirm you, it means you are not really doing your work properly.
How come you are the first that is confirmation will be this delayed and prolonged?
No, no problem. Maybe the others are happy that because there are a number of our people. People we are investigating. They are also in the National Assembly.
The National Assembly is claiming that they have a DSS indicting report against you.
No, no.
And that's why
I don't want to join issue. I'm sure you heard my answer to that question.
Okay.
Right in the National Assembly.
Yeah.
Yes. So you can revisit that.
Yeah. Okay. But now,
I'm not completely distracted. It's not an issue. Rather, it pushed me. It gives me courage.
You don't see it as a setback.
You have to be here to know the kind of. You wake up very early in the morning. You see some terrible publication about you. You know, instead of justifying all this. We are determined to go ahead. I cannot be distracted with those things. You need to be, you need to check the social media and listen to the TV, etc., to know what is going on.
Yeah, there are some people who believe that it's because you're rocking the boat and you are doing the hatchet man's job. That's why some people are not comfortable with your position here. But when you
nobody can purchase me. I cannot compromise what I'm doing. But to say that I'm one side is not right.
How much do you think you could have recovered given the necessary support?
Well, we have a focus for every year. We have a strategy for every year. I don't have it readily available. In this D400 and something, there is classification. There are monies we help NNPC to recover from the oil marketers. This is not readily available to the government. There is a difference between what we recover and internally generated revenue. Mm. We are not revenue generating entity or agency. So whatever we recover, we assisted the NNPC and recover about 300 and something billion naira from the oil marketers. This one will have to go to the NNPC. That was what I agreed. It's paid to NNPC. And it will go undergo some processes before whatever is due to the government is paid to the federal government. There is a job we have done for Federal Inland Revenue Services. We recover withholding tax and pay taxes from banks, and this is paid to them. The number of properties we recover, the value has not stated. You understand? I have not stated the amount we recover in the case of amount we are able to recover. We recover cash in his house, and the cash that was also broke as a result of our intervention in the board of the Nigeria Intelligence Agency. We have not stated all this. It's another statement. I don't want to be seen to be blowing my trumpet. Mm. Yes.
Now, people feel that in spite of the numerous efforts you're making to fight corruption, that the biggest obstacle is coming from within. And that
promoting how?
When we saw,
what do you think is the biggest obstacle in fighting
when
corruption?
We saw
I said, what do you
when,
think?
When we saw the EFCC trying to arrest the former DSS boss,
yes,
and there was a very strong resistance,
yes,
how did you feel?
I feel disappointed. It's very, very unprofessional. Very, I have been in this job for a very long time. I have never seen a situation like that.
Let's look at the President Buhari anti-corruption champion status at the African Union. He seems to be a hero abroad, but he's been much criticized at home.
No, who so, criticizes him? Is it for the corrupt people that criticize him? It's not real. The criticism is not real. It's a paid criticism. People are paid to do their hard work in the in social media, in media, etc., etc. It's paid. It's the looters, and we will reach out. We will recover every cobble and return them to tradition.
For now, what's the biggest challenge you see?
The biggest challenge is the corruption fighting back. Yes.
Is it because the institution is not strong enough to tackle this corruption that now?
We are trying our best. You know, fighting corruption is not one man business. It's every Nigerian has a responsibility in fighting corruption. So we need the support of everybody to key in. There's no way one institution will be charged in fighting corruption. So we are also collaborating with everybody. We are calling on every Nigerian to join us in the fight against corruption. Give us information. Even if you help us sustain Nigerians to know that corruption is wrong. Because some people don't even believe that corruption is wrong. So if you can join me in the fight against corruption, it will help. You can generally join me in the fight against corruption. You are just you are a corruption fighter. Have you ever declared that?
Okay, but people see you as walking a tight rope. Do you sometimes feel
it doesn't matter. You see, there is no way anybody can meet up the challenges when you come to here. Yes. We just try and do what you can do and go and rest at home. Tomorrow morning you wake up and handle whatever you can. You try your best.